अगेन आई एम टेलिंग यू दिस थिंग दैट इफ यू आर अटेंडिंग ऑल द पीरियड्स ओनली देन यू विल बी मार्क्ड प्रेजेंट बिकॉज इन मॉर्निंग आई वाज टेकिंग अटेंडेंस एंड आई हैव नोटेड ओनली फोर स्टूडेंट्स वर मार्क्ड प्रेजेंट इन यस्टरडेज अटेंडेंस व्हाई सो बिकॉज ओनली फोर स्टूडेंट्स वर देयर इन ऑनलाइन हु हैव अटेंडेड ऑल द पीरियड्स सम स्टूडेंट्स वर देयर हु हैव अटेंडेड टू पीरियड्स हु हैव अटेंडेड थ्री They have not attended all online classes, so I'm sorry to say that they all are marked absent by me. Am I clear? Voice is not clear. I'm speaking so loudly. So, बच्चे एम आई क्लियर यू आर सपोज टू अटेंड ऑल ऑनलाइन क्लासेस एंड ऑफलाइन स्टूडेंट्स अगेन योर दैट कंसेंट फॉर्म विल बी चेक इफ एनी ऑफ द स्टूडेंट इज सिटिंग हियर एंड दे हैव नॉट गिवन देयर कंसेंट फॉर्म दे विल बी सेंट आउट दे विल बी मार्क्ड एब्सेंट एंड दे विल बी सेंट टू देयर होम So yesterday we were doing poem. I have kept in my Almira. I have taken from you. Now we were doing No Man Are Foreign. So take out that poem. So we were doing that poem. No Man Are Foreign. Bachche, what is the problem, Arvind? So get ready with that. No man are foreign. No men are foreign. Okay, so this beautiful poem, this message giving poem is written by James Kirkham. So yesterday when I was explaining you this poem, we have discussed three poetic devices. What was the first poetic device? Simile. Simile is used when as and like is given, and after that assonance is given when repetition of vowels is given, and after that And I have discussed about rhyme scheme. The poem is written in three verse. It has no rhyme scheme. So we have discussed all about things yesterday in this poem, and we were on stanza number 4, and the bell went on, so we couldn't complete stanza 4. So let's continue with this stanza number 4. It is the human earth that we defile. Our hells of fire and dust outrage the innocence of air that is everywhere our own. Remember, no men are foreign and no countries strange. This boy come on the first desk. Harnoor come on second last. This girl go at last third. Ramanjit. So now in this stanza, the poet is saying that when we are having weapons, when we are having arms, you can say weapons against each other, And when we are doing such kind of activity, so what does it mean? If we are caring against, carrying weapons against each other, it means we are polluting the spirit. We are polluting the whole humanity. Okay, we are destroying the whole humanity. Because in this way, we are not polluting ourselves. We are not polluting not only society. We are not polluting not only our nation. In this way, we are polluting the whole earth on which we all are living. Am I clear? I'm going so slow so that each and every meaning should be very much clear to you, that when we are doing this kind of activity means that when we are having the weapons in our hands and we are keeping all those weapons against each other, we are using it for fighting purpose. So we are polluting the whole earth on which we are living. So which kind of disqualities we are spreading? We are having jealousy. We are having hatred. Okay. So we are having jealousy. We are having hatred. Okay. So in this way, we are spoiling the innocence of people. Okay. It means we are not doing anything good. We are doing everything bad. We are spoiling the whole environment. Okay, we are spreading jealousy. We are spreading hatred. Okay, so by doing all these things, we are not committing mistakes. We are committing blunders. We are committing blunders. So by doing all the things, we are committing blunders in this way. Okay, and we are all having this false perception. Perception means our viewpoint, that this thing belongs to me, that thing belongs to me, I possess this thing. But everything, all these are perspective is completely wrong, because we all are brothers. We all have same humanity. We all have same blood. We all are living on a same earth. We all are sharing same water. We all have same life. We also take birth, we also die. So same like those so-called strangers, they also have a same life. So we should understand this thing. By fighting, we want to prove this thing, that this is ours. This nation is ours. This is your nation. And we are fighting and we want to control on them. But by doing all these activities, we are really doing wrong things. We are not doing right things at all. So am I clear? This concept is clear. So now let's discuss question answers. Beneath all uniforms, what is the meaning of beneath? Yes. So beneath means under. Beneath means under, and what are the uniforms? I know uniform means clothes, but whose uniforms are we talking? Yes. Whose uniforms are being talked about? Soldiers' uniforms. So beneath all uniform, it means those who are wearing uniforms. It means the people, those who are standing on their borders, on their duties. Who are they? They are soldiers. So the poet is speaking about the uniforms of soldiers. Okay. And beneath all uniforms, it means they all are having different uniforms. It means some are having different colors. Some are having different castes. So what kind of uniforms are denoting that these soldiers can of different colors, caste, creed, religion. So all these also come into the category of uniforms. So we all have different uniforms. It means my caste can be different, your caste can be different. My religion can be different, your religion can be different. But it doesn't mean that we are strangers. We all are same. Which kind of relation we are having? We are all living on a same earth. We are all sharing same water, same air, same feelings. Okay? So here, bachche, so the poet is speaking about uniforms of different. Switch on that light. So we all are having same uniform means the poet is speaking about the uniform of different caste, creed, religion, okay, nationalities also of the people, nationalities also. Nationalities also of all the people, okay. So how does the poet say that all the people living on this earth are same? Because we all have same body, we are all having same feelings, same emotions, living on same earth. Yes. Yes. So we all have same resources. We all have same feelings of love. So in this way, we can say that people on earth all are same. Am I clear to you? So who is going to tell me first and second answer in detail? I'm giving you time to frame first and second answer in detail. Yes.
It's like the point is that on the earth, everything is same. Nothing is different. These workers, whether caste, religions, are not same, but their rights.
Religiously, religion.
Whether caste are not same, but their rights are not same. But
Jashan, write down English attendance. You have written off math.
That's why in this point, the quiet suggests the all things that the people of the same.
Aryan, good. Aryan, Dhiren, Ikjot, Jayati, Parmeet, Aman, Sudiksha, Sumati. So now these 8 participants are supposed to attend all the classes. Only then they will be marked present. Otherwise, if you miss any of the online class, you will be considered absent. Clear? So it is a hard and fast rule. You have to follow strictly. Okay, same answer, Kriti Verma. Sorry, Kirti Singh. Yug. Because when I was discussing, you were so busy with Akhilesh. Your name is Akhilesh. My discussion was useless, having no value, that's why. Okay, Renuka. To whom I have given this duty? Have you done that? So during recess you can do.
What is speaking about? He is saying that they may have been different culture, past,
nationalities. Good. Simran, same answer. You come here. See, Simran always writes so well. So now she is going to tell about her answer. Listen carefully.
The uniforms about which the poet is speaking is the soldiers. Soldiers can be of different caste, creed, or religion, but they have the same feelings and are same. This beautiful poem, No Men Are Foreign, is written by James Kirkup, in which he tries to tell us that there is no stranger. Just see how deep his thinking goes, and this is just the starting. Poet tells us that all the people on the earth are same. We are all one, and we all have same feelings, resources, and we all come under the category of humanity, and we shall stay in it and don't be jealous or discover hatred for others, and also help others in their mistakes and all.
Help there, there. Now let's move to next question. In stanza one, find five ways in which we all are alike. Pick out the words. So let's make a list of five things in which you can say that we all are alike. Alike means we all are same. So how is that? No men are strange. No countries foreign. So pick up these lines from the stanza. No countries. So a single body. Tell me. A single body breathes. A single body breathes beneath all uniforms. Beneath all uniforms. Then afterwards, we all share same earth. We all share same earth. Okay, then we all share same earth. Then same air. So you can pick up all these points. So you can pick up these points. With the help of these points, you can frame your answer. Start writing. According to stanza number one, you have to find out. We all shall lie,
yes,
on the same earth.
Yes, ma'am.
So the land we are sharing, that is same. Okay. So the land is same everywhere. So this text is clear. So next question we have is, how many features, common features, can you find in stanza two? How many common features? All of you find out, go through stanza number two. Go through stanza number two. And what are the common features that we find out? Tell me. Common features of sun, air, and water. Common features of sun, air and water are also fed by peaceful harvest. They also fed by peaceful harvest. After that, it means their hands are like us. Yes, they also starve. Who told? Good. They also starve in the war. So starving in the war. They are starving in the war. And yes, same labor. Okay, so this labor not different from our own. So you can pick up all these hints. With the help of these hints, you can frame your answer. Clear? Am I clear to you?
Yes.
Points. Now next question we have is, you can pick up these hints. With the help of these hints, you can frame your answer. If they have asked about points, you will be writing in points. Otherwise, you will be writing in paragraph. Now done. Now let's move to next question. Next question we have is, whenever we are told to hate our brothers, when do you think this happens? Why? Who tells us? Should we do as we are told at such times? What does the poet say? Whenever we are told to hate our brothers, so this line, just go in the detail of this line. Whenever we are told to hate our brothers, what is the meaning of this line? I don't want to listen in Hindi explanation. Yes. Who tells us? See, there are so many people who have selfish motives. So they tell that this war should be started. Okay. So the people who have selfish motives, who want to spread riots, etc. Okay. Who are thinking only about themselves, who are not thinking about others, and who want that, yes, there should be a war. And they tell soldiers to be ready for the war. Okay. So they are the ones who tell us to prepare for wars. There are so many people who are having a selfish motive. Who are having selfish motives, okay? They want to conquer others. They want to conquer others. Harana, to defeat some others. The people who are having selfish motives, who are having selfish motives, who want to conquer others, who want to defeat others, who want to defeat others, who want to conquer others, okay? And they tell us to prepare for, they tell us to prepare for, prepare for wars, okay. So should we do as we are told as such times? Suppose any war is going on and it is told that, yes, that nation is our enemy. We should hate them. Should we do that? No, not at all. We should not do things that they way, because other countrymen are also like us. They're also human beings. They also have emotions like us. Okay? So the poet is very much true in saying this thing, that no man is strange and no country is a foreign country. Clear? So when we are told to hate others, we should not think about this. We should not do as they are telling us, that we should hate others. It doesn't mean that people who are living in another nations, they are enemies. No, not at all. So all of you frame your answer. Frame your answer. Yes. Aparan, you tell me what have you written? Okay, take 2 minutes to frame this long answer. Nitish, write down. Raise your hand whose answers are ready. Yes. Very good. So instead of fighting, we should live in peace. We should not listen to those persons who tell us to hate other nations, because we should stand, we should take our stand, we should think wisely that they are not our enemies. They are also having same emotions, feelings. They are just like us. If duty is assigned to our soldiers, same duty is assigned to other soldiers. So they are fighting because they are under pressure. Okay, they are fighting because they are told to do so. Because they are given this duty because of their selfish motives. So we should never think about like this. Now, same answer, Yug.
Fighting to conquer with Arjuna. We should conquer with love. We should, the poet said that we should conquer with love. All the people are as same as. They are following the same way. They are thinking the same way. They are drinking the same air. They are drinking the same water. And, but some people are, but some people want to conquer for their selfish motives. And they are prepared, and they are preparing for wars. But we should do with them. But we should do with them.
Soldiers. Pronunciation is soldiers. Good. Now next, I'm going to give you one long question. Write down. Explain how does our hatred jealousy and misdeed pollute our earth? Explain how does our hatred, jealousy and misdeed pollute our earth? See, the whole of the world is a union. We all are in the same way. We all are like, we all are alike, same, okay? We may belong to different religion, different caste, different culture, different nation, but we all are sharing same earth. We all are sharing same air, water, sun, our love, emotions, feelings, all are alike, okay? So if we are in brotherhood, we think about all the things, then really we can realize this thing that it is really a joy to being together. If we all are being together, they will also be in joy, we also will be in joy. But if we will hate each other, they will also be in pain. We also will be in pain. They also have to suffer. We also have to suffer. Okay? There will also be loss of property, loss of human lives. And same in our nation also. If war is there, we will have a loss of property, loss of human lives. So like this. Yes. Yes. It means we should not favor war at all. We should not favor war at all. We should think only about peace. So you will take the gist of the chapter. Listen, Jaskirat. So we should think only and only about love. We should not hate anybody. We should not think about that jealous. Okay, by inculcating all these points, you can frame a long answer. Okay? Now you will be doing this answer in your fair notebook. Clear?